What is the one reason, the big reason as to why Mother's Day is normally celebrated far much more than Father's Day or Men's Day and so on? I can tell you the answer. Mothers simply have a high sense of ownership. They show a very high sense of ownership as compared to fathers, as compared to men. And that's why the world rewards them much more royally. Now, in the podcast, I am talking about personal branding, and I'm going to tie this one in. What are some of those steps that you can be able to take in order to craft yourself a great and compelling personal brand? We're going to use the story of mothers today to learn just one critical aspect of personal branding. Stay tuned.
Welcome to the Life Signatures Podcast with Lawrence Namale. Lawrence is a life coach, author, and keynote speaker who loves to tackle different topics on purpose, productivity, and resilience. His mission in life is to awaken all your boundless possibilities available in you. Life Signatures Podcast is dedicated to bring to reality every single person who knows that deep down in their gut, there's got to be more to life than this. And now, here is your host, Lawrence Namale.
Now, I've said very many times on these episodes, the past several episodes, that personal branding is your next CV, is the new CV, is a new kid on the block. Why? Because the world is filled with so many traditionally qualified and competent people, and some of these very many highly qualified people are lost in the crowd. They are lost in the noise. The world has become so noisy today that it is so difficult to find the quality that you're looking for. In fact, becomes so difficult for you to stand out as a person of quality. And the answer to that question, how can I become a person of quality, a person that can be seen, a person that can stand out from the crowd? The answer is simply this, that you're going to intentionally craft a personal brand. Because this world is responding to clarity. This world responds to people who are authentic, people who are truthful, people who are unique, people who are offering a solution, people who are problem solvers, people who are adding value. And guess what? All those things are done through a personal brand. And we say that everyone on the face of the earth has a personal brand. Everyone does have a personal brand. And the question is, do they know it? That's why the first step in creating a personal brand is to know who you are, to know that you do have a brand. And that's what we're discussing in this episode, that every single person is unique and their uniqueness moves into the world. In other words, you can be as obscure and maybe as weird as anything in the face of the earth. That does not mean that you're not needed. Your uniqueness is important on the face of the earth. The cactus is needed in the desert, just like the eucalyptus is needed in the tropics. All our uniqueness comes together and forms one beautiful world. That's why you are needed. Your uniqueness is needed. The personal brand that you're going to build has got to be unique, has got to be authentic, has got to be truthful, has got to offer value, has got to solve a problem, has got to deliver someone, has got to position you as a hero for someone, has got to rise you up as a villain against something or someone. That's how a brand is normally built. So the very first step that we discussed in the episode yesterday is that you need to know who you are. You cannot form a personal brand that is away or divorced from who you really are. Who you really are forms what you're going to do and forms who you're going to be in terms of a hero, in terms of someone who is going to rise up against a villain, one way or another. So know who you are. This is one of the most forgotten aspects of life, where people are not looking at themselves first. People are looking at the world to get a reference. You see, when you're looking at the world, you should be looking at where you're going to solve, where you're going to give a solution, where you're going to add value, not where the world is going to define you from. You're not defined by the world. You go into the world with already crafted definition that now solves the world's problems. So the first step in creating a personal brand is to know who you are. Know what your gifts are, know what your talents are, know what you're compassionate about, know what you're passionate about. That's when you start crafting this personal brand around those things. And we live in a world where people are running helter-skelter, looking for different kinds of things that are not authentic with them, things that they're not passionate about, things that they're not naturally attuned to, gifted to, they're not tuned and in harmony with those things. And now people end up being incongruent in the world. And that's why very many people get lost. If you are passionate about children, then know that that is your passion and that forms one of the pillars of your personal brand. So know who you are. If you do not know who you are, there is a problem with your personal brand. And by the way, every single time you're awake, every single time your blood is being pumped by your heart, you are exuding a brand. How people are going to perceive you is another question. And that's why you need to step back and look at, who really am I? And from that angle, you start building a personal brand. So once you know who you are, you focus on that incessantly. You go after it with focus, it's deep focus, and so on and so forth. Now, the second step in creating a nice, compelling, powerful personal brand, I've already alluded to it, is simply this. You need to become a hero. How many songs have been sung about heroes? And if you look at the collection of songs that have been sung about heroes, I can tell you this, a great percentage of those songs are related to mothers. I can tell you that. I mean, song after song after song, you talk about Spice Girls, you talk about Britney Spears, you talk about Tupac Shakur, you talk about Boyz II Men, you talk about Eddie. Big names, if they were to pay tribute, it is to the mama. And why is that? It's because the mama has simply become a hero. I mean, how does a mama become a hero? The mama becomes a hero by owning her calling. That is the second step. You become a hero by owning your calling. And this is where it's important for you to have known who you are and believed that you were meant to be who you are and be comfortable in that. It leads you to accepting your position as someone else's hero confidently, authentically, passionately. You will not form any personal brand if you are not passionate, if you are not consumed to owning that particular brand of yours, if you're not totally sold out to offering value with love, with care, with compassion to the people that are actually your audience. There is no creating a personal brand just, you know, professionally, you just band things together and you go out and just start telling people. If there is no aspect of ownership, if there is no aspect of compassion, if there is no aspect of love, if there is no aspect of care, that's what defines a mama. If there is no aspect of those things, then that personal brand is going to fall, is going to crumble. And that's why we said in some of the episodes that I've passed that there are several misconceptions about personal branding. And some of these misconceptions are that brands are for competing, brands are for selling, brands are for marketing, you know, brands are for getting things from the world. Wrong. Brands, personal brands are for service. They are for offering value. They are for running the villain out of town. So you need to rise up as a hero. You need to look at yourself. The way you consider yourself at the back of your mind is going to actually be reflected in the eyes of your audience. Remember, your personal brand is about the story that people are telling about you. That is what is going to be reflected in their eyes when at the back of your mind you consider yourself a hero of sorts. And how are you going to do that? Someone might be asking, how in the world am I going to create myself as a hero? Remember that personal branding is not about standing out of a crowd. It is about what difference you will make. It is how different you're going to appear. That is the cardinal rule in creating a compelling personal brand. It is making a difference. You're positioning yourself to be someone else's hero. Not very many people. Someone. You cannot, let me not go into a tangent and talk about doing everything for everyone. If you find yourself doing everything for everyone, listen, you do not have a personal brand, a compelling personal brand. You're spreading yourself too thin. Indeed, a personal brand is a story about a hero who comes to town and saves people out of their most difficult problems, the nagging problems they have been waiting all their lives, dealing with this oppression all their lives, until the hero shows up. The hero comes to town. So how are you going to position yourself as a hero? I think there are three things that you can be able to do. The first thing, you need to package your backstory. Every hero has a story. Remember in the episode yesterday, we said everyone has a story. Everyone has a song. Everyone is a little different. Everyone has a story. Every hero has an origin, has a backstory. They have what they believe in. They have some turmoil that they have going through. They have some conflict that they have been able to overcome. You have your own story. Your story might easily connect with your audience, to your personal brand, because they identify. They identify with your struggles of the past. They identify with what you've overcome. They identify with those things that you are passionate about. They identify with those things that are values to you. A true hero is never someone who is perfect. So your imperfections. I remember some years ago writing a story about someone who did not have some qualifications and so on, and yet they were doing great stuff. And whatever I wrote cost a lot of star, and I was forced to pull that down because they were looking at this mindset that a hero is perfect. No, a hero is not necessarily someone who is perfect. A hero is someone with scars. So what are your scars? What are those things that you have overcome? Someone who has overcome something and now they're in the pole position to help others, because a deliverer will never deliver people unless they share in their pain, unless they know how it feels to be rejected, how it feels to fail, how it feels to try and write a book and you're not able to write it until you're able to write and become a bestseller. The hero knows the scars. The hero has the scars. They know the wounds. A hero is also someone who they got their transformation through something that they went through, and now they have become passionate one way or another about it. So I don't know what it is that you've gone through. That could be part and parcel of your brand, because you're positioning yourself to help those ones who will go through the same thing. So you form your backstory. You identify what things that are causing conflict or cause conflict that you are able to overcome. Identify what struggles you are able to overcome. Identify those things that you value the most in your life. Identify the messes that you went through. Identify the wounds that you've gone through. Put them in your backstory. Don't be afraid. I normally tell people, I don't have a degree and that's part of my backstory. And I would have loved to have it, but I don't have it. All right? So identify that and put it in your backstory, because my backstory has, these things of the normal conventional way of thinking is that if you don't have a degree, you're not going to make it in life. And so my backstory is, I don't have one and I'm making it in life. And I'm called to deliver those people who do not have, for one reason or another. Maybe they are not competent enough, or maybe their families were not able to rise up enough resources for them, and so on and so forth. But they still need to be alive in this world, and they still need to make a difference. So my backstory has that. So number one, if you're going to be a hero, create your backstory. Number two, identify your villain. I mean, identify the guy that you're already up against. Everyone has something they're up against. Every hero has something they are rising up against. You cannot be a hero if you do not have a villain. Every hero has a nemesis, a villain. In fact, there is no way you're building a compelling personal brand without that aspect of what are you fighting? What are you solving? What problem are you solving? What is it that you're passionate about? What are you angry about? And on the flip side, what do you love? Because what you love is on the flip side of what you hate. For example, my villain increasingly is overcoming the status quo. You can say status quo for me is my villain. Status quo says that if you don't have a degree, you're not going to win in life. Status quo says that you need to be book smart in order to excel. Status quo says that you need to be connected in order to excel. Status quo says very many things, and status quo has very many very many victims around the earth. Very many of them. People with filled with potential, people who fill with promise, they are being sacrificed on the altar of status quo, and that becomes my villain. So I go after this villain with all that I have got, and I say, listen, you cannot kill anymore, you cannot take people to their graves with potential anymore. I'm rising up against you. In fact, that is what I am doing on a daily basis in this podcast. So I feel that it is the greatest robber of people's potential, people's purpose, people's productivity. And frankly, you might have more than one villain, and your personal brand has to address the villain squarely. Squarely. There's got to be a villain that you're rising up against squarely. So if you're going to be a hero, identify your villain. You might have gone through a rough patch in your life. That becomes a villain. Some people have risen up, and for example, there is a lady who called her organization MAD, M-A-D-D, Mothers Against Drunk Driving. Her villain was drunk driving, and it formed part and parcel of her personal brand. Okay, because she went through it. How did she go through it? Her child, her girl, a little girl, was killed by a drunk driver, and so that became her villain. You might have been, God forbid, raped. And now you become that aspect of rapist. They become your villain, and your brand is focused around that. I'm going to move away from those things, sad things. Number three, if you're going to be rising up as a hero, you need to answer your calling. A person with a personal brand is someone who has experienced pain enough to rise up and seek to deliver the people that he or she is leading. Your audience, they need to identify that this man is working as if he's been called. He's not doing this to be paid. That is the aspect of a calling. A calling is akin to a purpose. It is communicating that you are born to do this. You are created to do this. You are in this place at this time for this reason. And no one can pay you enough. If you do not have a call that you've answered, there is no personal brand that you're going to build. None. Zilch. Contrary to popular belief, a call is not a religious, facade, religious experience, and therefore it's not limited to religion only. Every single human being is called. We have to answer that call, and when we do, we are building a personal brand. And number four, to create a great hero, you need to have a moral code. I mean, every hero has moral code. A personal brand has some non-negotiables, some values. It has some values, some standards that you subscribe to. People know this moral code and these values. They will know that this hero can never do this. This hero can never do that. For Steve Jobs, the moral code was finesse. Excellence inside the motherboard, where you will not see, and it's simplicity and innovation. That was his moral code. You cannot think of Steve Jobs' personal brand without having that moral code standing out. So all great heroes always will have values that they espouse, moral codes that they subscribe to, standards that they adhere to. That moral code is derived from drawing a line in the sand and stating what you are about, what you are for, and what you are against. See, without having that distinction, the personal brand is not complete. So all brands out there, think about all the brands out there, great brands out there, none of them lacks a moral code. And lastly, if you're going to rise up as a hero in creating your personal brand, you need to have a symbol, a logo. I mean, it goes without saying that a personal brand is identified uniquely, okay, uniquely, by how it is packaged. This is where unique symbols comes in. For people, their name alone is a logo. I mean, it represents their brand, and this is because they have produced so much value, so much problem solving. They have gone against the villain so much. They have won against the villain so much that their name is just, their image is synonymous with that brand. But a symbol is important to create this distinction I'm talking about. All great brands, they have a symbol. Think of Apple, Nike, Coca-Cola, the English Premier League, Tesla, IBM, KFC, the flag of any country. That symbol is a graphic that easily condenses all that is representative of that brand into a pictorial representation. So in conclusion, you create a great personal brand when you choose to become a hero. You become a hero by, number one, creating your backstory, number two, identifying the villain, number three, answering your calling, number four, creating a moral code, and number five, creating a symbol. Until tomorrow, where we'll conclude this small mini series. Bye bye. A special shout out to my mentor Jeffrey Howard of Visionary Business University, found at mastermindmentor.com, who has graciously provided me with the soundtrack and the introductory track to this podcast. Thank you, Jeff.
Thank you for listening to Life Signatures Radio. If you enjoyed today's show, subscribe to Life Signatures Radio on iTunes, Stitcher, or visit our website at lifesignatures.libsyn.com. Life Signatures Radio, fresh, clean, and inspiring.